Mine for a Moment, written by Mara-Tabea Sarcevic. Narrated by Joshua Pearson. I still don't know how I even got invited to this Halloween party in the first place. Probably just because I was standing right next to Damien when Sophie talked with him about it, so she just graciously included me in her invitation. But who cares? Zoe's coming too. Which is why I'm kind of freaking out right now. I don't know her very well, but my guess is she'll take this whole dressing up thing very seriously, so I can't fuck it up. She already thinks I'm a dull bore, which means a scream mask or a white sheet with holes in it won't do. Are you done with your inner monologuing? Hannah quips from behind me and brings me back to the present. Embarrassed, I nod to show her that I'm with her again. Hannah is the kindergarten teacher of my two younger siblings and volunteered to help me when I told her about my costume predicament. She's really good with makeup, which every kid who ever got to enjoy becoming a butterfly or a lion by her hand would testify to. Together we decided, well, basically she told me what to do and I said yes, that I would go as a kind of gentleman skeleton. I think she called it Dia something something muertos, but I'm sticking with the gentleman skeleton. The good thing is that I can just wear black trousers, a black shirt, and a top hat she borrowed from her brother, so I don't have to buy a stupid costume I'm never going to wear again. We better start with your makeup, or you're not going to be fashionably late, but just rudely late. She bosses me around like she would her kindergartners, and before I know it, I find myself in a chair with closed eyes, trying not to break into giggles because the brushes she uses tickle my skin. After what feels like ages, even though it's just half an hour, she tells me to open my eyes and admire her work. Wow, I can't help but say. She lightly slaps my arm. No need to sound so surprised. You know I have mad makeup skills, she jokes, with barely concealed pride in her voice. And she has. I don't even recognize myself in the mirror. Instead of Henry, the always smiling face of a devious-looking skull stares back at me. The mass of black makeup around my eyes makes the green of them seem a lot more luminous than normal, which has an eerie effect. It's awesome. Thanks, Hannah. I mean it, I tell her and squeeze her hand. No one's gonna know it's me. She grins mischievously. And isn't that a wonderful thing? It means that certain prejudiced girls won't know what hit them. She must mean Zoe. I told her about her when I asked for her help. And maybe she is right. Maybe this is my chance to talk to Zoe and show her that I'm not the arrogant, boring jock she's been mistaking me for since we first met. Even though met might be the wrong word for when someone runs you over with their skateboard. I hope so, Han, I hope so, I answer with a soft groan. She winks at me, grabs the top hat from the desk behind her and places it on my purple hair, previously dyed for the occasion. There, now you're ready. Go and have fun, and just remember, you're wearing a costume. You can be who or whatever you want tonight. Before I get the chance to answer her, the door opens and my youngest sister Emma waddles in. One look at me and her eyes go all big and round. She makes a scared little gasping noise, and to prevent her from screaming or crying or whatever I'm sure she was about to do, I kneel beside her, smile and say in a calming voice, "Hey little peanut, no need to be scared. It's just me, okay? Henry." I can see it in her eyes, the exact moment she recognizes me when I call her by her special nickname. I started calling her Peanut after we had to see the doctor for the third time because she'd shoved one of those little suckers up her nose. Henry? She asks, bewildered, and I have to smile because no one in this world says my name as adorably as Emma does, with her inability to properly pronounce the letter R. Hannah rushes forward and hoists her onto her hip. Doesn't Henry look scary? She asks her in mock seriousness. Emma cocks her head as if she's thinking really hard. Why scare we? She simply asks, which makes me and Hannah laugh. He's going to a party for scary people. To win the heart of a scary girl, Hannah says in a slightly spooky voice. Emma just nods satisfied, as if that explains everything. She starts wiggling, so Hannah puts her back on the floor. She then proceeds to hug my left leg very tightly before waddling out of my room again. I shake my head in amazement. Children are remarkable, and I envy Hannah because she actually gets to work with them every day. It's what I want to do in the future too. Children are just... You're starting another inner monologue, aren't you? Hannah interrupts my thoughts. You have a party to attend. Come on, I'll drop you off on my way home. Sophie has outdone herself. I guess I shouldn't be that surprised about it, because if there is one person I know who would turn even a Halloween party into a big event, it's Sophie.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.